So in today's lecture, we're going to see types of analysis. To analyze the given algorithm, we need to know with which input algorithm takes less time and which input the algorithm takes a long time. So types of analysis mein kya hai? We have to see that ki kaun sa inputs less time le raha hai and kaun sa inputs taking the long time. So here three types of there of analysis. The three types of analysis there. Three types of analysis. Let's see. Here you can say three types of case are there. We show the which one is best and which one is good. The first one is worst case. So in this, let me increase. The first one is the worst case. Okay. So in this, if the running time of algorithm is longest for all the inputs, then it is called worst case. In this type, the key operation are executed maximum number of times. Means isme kya hai, agar if running time agar longest hoga, running time of algorithm is longest, then it is called the worst case. Okay, and next is the best case. One minute. In best case, if the running time of input, if the running time of the algorithm is shortest for all the inputs, then it is called best case. Matlab running time algorithm ka running time short hoga, so it's called a best case. Okay, in this type, the key operation are execute maximum number of time. And you know, I hope you understand that worst case means if running time of algorithm ka input ka long hoga, that is worst, and if it's shortest, then it's called best. And what is about average case? So average here, in average case, if running time of algorithm falls between worst case and best case, it is called the average case. To calculate the average case complete complexity of algorithm, we have to take some assumption. Okay, let's see. For example, searching for element in unsorted array of length n. Okay, if we found the desired element at first position, okay, then number of comparison will be best case. If we found the desired element at last position, then number of comparison will be worst case. Agar elements humne first position mein find kiya, that is for best. And if we find the last position, that is worst. If we assume it is found roughly in the middle position, not first, not last, but middle. Okay, array. Then we need to do n by 2 comparisons to get the desired element. So it is average case. Okay, average case is average case falls between the worst and best. Okay, now next point is about asymptotic notation. Okay. Let's see here this. In asymptotic notation, are language that allow us to analyze algorithms running time by identify its behavior as the input size for the algorithm increases. It is used to find out which algorithm is better for the same problem statement. Okay, so asymptotic notation having some means following are the common asymptotic notation are there to calculate the running time. So let's see this. The first one is big O notation. Big O notation. Okay, so this big O notation is indicated by O. Or the symbol of big O notation is O. Then we can say big omega notation. Big omega notation. which is indicate with the help of O symbol, omega symbol, right? So let's take the omega symbol from here. So here omega symbol is there. Okay. So this indicate by omega symbol, then theta shift notation, theta you can say theta notation, which is indicated by theta sign. Let's take again symbol from here, theta. Okay, so is there here only. Okay, close it. Okay, so these are the three types we can see here. Asymptotic notation, big omega notation, then second is a big omega notation. First is big O notation, which is indicated by O, then second is a big omega notation, which is indicated by omega sign, and theta notation, which is indicated by a theta notation. So here all the this notation are used to express the complexity of algorithm. This all the notation is express the complexity of algorithm. Complexity can be defined as the rate at which the storage or time requirement grows as a function of problem size. Complexity is the time and space requirement of algorithm. If the time and space requirement of the algorithm is more, then complexity of algorithm is more. And if time and space requirement of algorithm is less, then complexity of algorithm is less. Matlab, agar time and algorithm is more hoga, then complexity of algorithm will be more. And if time and requirement is less, then algorithm will be less. Out of two factors, time and space, the space requirement is of algorithm is not very important. Okay. Space requirement is important because it is available at very low cost. Only the time requirement of algorithm is considered as an important factor to find the complexity. Because of importance of time, finding the complexity, it is a sometime term as a time complexity. So let's see this one by one. So here big O notation is there. Let's see first this one. Okay, big O notation. Okay, so in this is the first. Okay, big O notation. Big O notation gives the upper bound. Okay, you can say it gives the upper bound. Okay, upper bound. Okay, so of the function, upper bound of the function. Okay, function. Big O notation gives the upper bound of the function. It measures the worst case. So it measures the worst case time. Okay, it's used to measure worst case time complexity or the longest amount of time and algorithm possibly take the complete. This means a function f of x, a function f of x is a big O notation, big O function. F of x is a big O notation, big O notation, big O of function. Okay, and g of function, g of x, and so f of x, a function f of x is a big O function, and g of x, and there exists positive constant c. Then here f of x there, then g of x. And positive constant c, positive constant is called, constant is indicated by c. Okay, I'm right here, like const indicated by c. Okay, and not and not. Okay, success dad. Let's see the function. So okay, so here f of n is less than and equal to c into g of n. Okay, so where c is greater than 0 and c is greater than 0 and n naught is greater than 1, c is greater than 0, n naught is greater than 1, and let me see here that a big O notation of its upper bound of function. So f of x is a big O function, g of x and positive constant c and n naught. F of n is greater than and equal to and c into g of n, where c is greater than 0 and n naught is greater than 1 for all n naught is equal greater than equal to n naught. F of n is equal to omega ya or big O notation g of n of n of n. So here f of x and g of x are the function of non-negative integer. So these two are the function of non-negative integer. Okay, so let's consider one example here. Suppose f of n is equal to 2n plus 4. Okay, and g of n, let me type this example, then we will discuss. Okay, so this is the consider one example. So f of n, okay, example, this is f of n is equal to 2n plus 4 and g of n equal to n, then prove that f of n is equal to o g of n. Okay, so here for sum, then you can say, you can take directly this question also. F of n, we know the we have seen this f of n, and we have to apply this one f of n and g of n on me. Okay, f of n is greater than or equal to c into g of n for n is greater than 0. Okay, so for sum, c is, you know very well now, here for sum c is greater than 0 and n naught is greater than 1, substitute m of n. So we have to what we have to substitute. Well, wait, let me take this one, prove this for, so substitute f of n is equal to n plus 4. Okay, so 2n plus 4 is equal to greater than equal to c of, and this is the theorem you have to understand, you have to write in your paper if it will be there offline exam. Okay, so when can be 2 of n less than or equal to c of n, means here 2n plus 4 is less than or equal to c of n. For above the case, value of c can be anything above 3 is better, and n not, one minute, let me take this. So what I said here, n not equal to 3. Okay, and not equal to 3. So here what I said, and then f of when the 2n plus 4 less than or equal to c of n, for above case, value of c can be anything above 3 is greater than n not equal to 3. So let's take 2 of n, just 1 minute. So we can see here substitute, we have proof here this. Okay, substitute of 2 plus n, then 2 plus n, we know that n naught is now 3. So instead of c of n, we have put the 3n, then we combine this n together, then we get the n 4 is greater than or equal to n. So it means for every n is greater than or equal to 4 at c is equal to 3. So f of n is equal to greater than or equal to c into g of n, which you want. Okay, we get this one, right, with the help of this. Which one? This. Okay. Okay, let me type here. See, I hope you understand this one, right? How it's came means we have take the three, then instead of the and we put this three, then we get means for every n is greater than equal to for every n is greater than equal to 4 at c equal to 3. So f of n is greater than equal to c into g of n. So you can see this, you can match from this, see this, with this one and this one, means we prove our theorem, our problem of big O notation here, because we have take three, then we can easy to prove it. So now big omega notation, this all about a big O notation. Now next is a big omega notation here. So in big omega notation, let me type a okay, so big O notation, omega notation give lower bound. In the big O notation, give the upper bound, it's give the lower bound. Okay, so big O notation is give lower bound. Okay, lower bound of the function, lower bound of the function. Okay. It means the base case time complexity. We have seen that big O notation is a low case, means worst case, and here big O notation give the lower bound. So it give lower bound of the function. So it measure the best case. The big O omega notation measures the best case time complexity of best amount of time algorithm possible to take the complete. This means a function f of x is big O. It means a function f of x is big omega. Okay, big omega of function g of x, of function g of x. Okay, and then x is positive, like this only. C is constant. So f of n, here again, f of n is greater than or equal to c into g of n, where c is greater than equal 0 and not is greater than one, the for all n is greater than n equal to n naught. Okay, so here f of n, this is the type of theorem which you have to understand or you have to write by yourself exam. So let's take the symbol first here, omega. Okay, so omega f of n is equal to omega of g of n. Sorry. Okay, so here, consider here f of x and g of x, the function of non-negative integer. Okay, so here f of x and g of x is a function of non-negative integer. So let's take the example here again. Consider a function. Let me write. Then we discuss. Okay. So consider the function f of n is equal to 3 plus n 3 n plus 2 and g of n equal to n. Prove that f of n equal to omega g of n for some c is greater than 0 and n naught is greater than 1. Substitute f of n is equal to 3 n plus 2. So here 3 n plus 2 is less than and equal to c of n, because we have to prove this, right? So we are taking this like c, where the can be, when can be 3 n plus 2 is greater than or equal to c of n, is greater than and equal to c of n. Okay, so for above case the value of c can be anything above 4 is better. Above case the value of c can be anything above 4 is better. So here 3n plus 2 is equal to, is greater than equal to c of n. Okay, 1 minute. So here 3n plus for above, when the 3n plus 2 is greater than and equal to, sorry, is here greater than equal to c of n. Okay, so what I said here is the for above case, c can be anything above 4 is better. So now we have to again do it. It means 3n plus 2n equal to 3n. Okay, you know, we will now we combine the n and we could do it. Okay, here not n is not there. Okay, put n equal to 2 here. Put n equal to 2, then we get that 8 is greater than equal to 6, right? Greater than in equal to 6. 3 into 6 and 6 plus 2, 8. So we get the, because see, if you put the 2, then we get here 8. And if you put here 2 and instead of n, then here we get a 6. So we get the 8 is greater than or equal to 6. It means 3 3n plus 2 is lower bound. It means 3n plus 2 is lower bound. Okay, then next is you have to prove like this only. If it okay, now then is theta notation. So let's move this link theta notation. So here in theta notation lies between upper bound and lower bound of algorithm. Using this, we can compute the average amount of time taken by any algorithm. It means a function f of x is a theta of function g of x, and there exists and three positive constant like c one, c two, and not such that zero. Let me write. Then we will see. So here theta notation is lies between upper bound and lower bound of an algorithm. Using this, we can compute the average amount of time taken by algorithm. Means it also lies between like worst case, like average case. Average case is lies between the best and worst. Like this, theta also lies between upper and lower bound. So we can compute the average amount of time taken by any algorithm. This means a function f of x is a theta of function g of x, and there exist three positive constants c1, c2, and c3. So 0 is greater than equal to c1 into g of n, and equal to greater than equal to f of n in, greater than f of n is greater than c2 into g of n for all n is not and not. Here f of x and g of x are function of non-integer. It may be noted f of n is equal to theta g theta notation if and only if. Okay, so f of n is equal to big O notation of g of n. F of n is equal to means you have to just come write like this only, because it is a common, it lies between both. So you can say like f of n is equal to O g of n. Okay, and f of n is equal to, let's take this symbol again, omega. This one omega. Omega is, because I said already it lies between both g of n. Okay, so it means after some input and not, the value of c1 into g of n should be less than or equal to of f of n, and c2 is into g of n should be greater than or equal to f of n. Means here it is a combination, it is a lies between greater than and less than. That is a slice between the omega and big O notation. Okay, so today's lecture's over here. Thank you.
Okay, any problem? Yes, Abdullah, Arfa, Bhushan, Faizan, Rutuja.
No, ma'am.
Okay, Ankaru? Okay, leave. You can leave now.